Hello, it's me again, the Naked Chef, and I'm here tonight going to show y'all how to make the perfect steak. Well, first thing you do is you got to go on the cheap, because nobody likes to eat a steak when they think, hey, I could have had a lobster instead. So you go on the cheap, go down to the good old grocery store and get you a few things to go on it. I love to cook mine in butter, but looks like I'm down to my last little bit of Land O'Lakes. I use half margarine, half butter, just to make it taste like I want it to taste. Now, I don't like none of that there seasoning on my steak, maybe just a little bit of Dale's. I'm using my electric skillet tonight, so let's turn it on high. I want to heat that thing up until that butter almost smokes, okay? All right, got me some Land O'Lakes butter. I found me a packet there's left over from good old Captain D's there. No, I don't have a camera with me, camera assistant with me tonight. And my hovering drone quit hovering. You know how I'm newfangled kind of things are. So I'm going to try to set you up here. I don't know if it's going to stay or not. See if I can set you up here looking at the... There we go. If I pull my pan a little closer there. Now, what I like to do, I like that aged steak. I'll go down to the local grocery store when they mark it down. This piece of steak was almost $4. They marked it down to $1.81. And I've been aging it for two more days and it still looks fine. So, also, go out and get you some pink Himalayan salt. Himalayan pink salt. You know why that's pink? Because of the same reasons that flamingos are pink. Shrimp. So it's going to give you a little bit of a flamingo shrimp taste. If you ain't never had a flamingo shrimp taste, just go out there and get you some of this good old butter. Hey, I got company out there. Y'all don't pay no attention to them. They come on in. Somebody in a Kia. Don't know anybody in a Kia. But I'm going to continue cooking my good old steak. Now, I like mine Chicago Rare. What I'm going to do is I'm going to flavor it with this here salt. It's pretty for $1.81, ain't it? Just put your pink salt on there. Give it a rub. Probably good if you soak that in water for a little while. I'm going to get me a little bit of sea salt to go on as well. I'm going to go with my old-fashioned newfangled sea salt, whatever it is. I guess the first salt was sea salt, wasn't it? And I'm going to salt both sides. And once you get your butter just nearly a smoked in there, you want to take and just... I'm going to sear it on both sides. Really good there. When I'm searing it, I like to move it around in the pan some. When you move it around the pan, you get all the hot spots. Get that butter soaking in. Make that pretty. Now look there. See that one side starting to look pretty good. When I flip it, I'm not going to do as long on the other side. Like I said, I like it Chicago rare. Like to eat like a bear. Got my pretty Corel print dinner plate there. One of my favorites. It's an old 70s plate. Now I'm about to take and flip her. And scoot her around in that butter again, that salt. See how pretty that seared up there? We're not wanting to do too much here. Like to go, just like to make sure it's not cold inside. But this one's been at room temperature for a few hours. So, got my Chicago rare. This good old grizzly bear. Give it just another minute or two and let y'all watch it cook on the inside there. Pull that out. Unplugged it so it's turned off. Heat up a little bit on that side and throw my fork in the pan. Anyway, there you got it. In just a few minutes, good old Chicago rare. Good steak, man. Well, we'll see y'all later. Sure do wish I had me a waiter. Be nice to have a cold beer brought to me right now. See y'all later. Bye-bye.